Chapter 8, Seaworthy. With the help of Imperial Commodore Ariana Highwind, the makeshift miners hit pay dirt, only to learn rare ore won't suffice. Cindy refers them to Holly, an engineer in Lestalem who knows how to treat Mythril.
Rise and shine, Prince Charming, we're here. Sounds like a spot of trouble's popped up at the power plant. Wish I could help, but I'm powerless to do anything I'm not ordered to. I'll leave the keeping of the peace to you.
Of course.
We got this.
Good luck, boys.
Thank you very much. Several hours later. Why is it always several? Sounds a bit like Tubular Bells from The Exorcist.
Loving that outfit, Noct.
Why don't you wear one?
Well, that's the only one. And if anyone stands a fighting chance in there, it's you. Forget about fashion and go.
It really does look awful, doesn't it? Like, properly terrible.
Testing. Do you read me?
Yes.
Just wanted to thank you for offering to clear out those demons. That'll give me time to treat this Mythril for you. There's a hunter who went in right ahead of you. I imagine there are too many for one to handle. But two of you should be fine. Then a little heads up. Getting some unstable readings from the generators inside. Too much power and the whole place could blow, so be quick.
Well, so, you my backup?
I thought we were partners.
Anyway, place is crawling with demons.
Wait a sec, you sound familiar.
Save the talk, we got hunting to do. Now, if we're done with the introductions, follow me.
I wonder who this could be. I mean, his size doesn't give away who he is at all. No. Oh, the light level's changed. By the way, let me through here.
There they are. You ready to run?
You ready to run? Right, do I have magic? I can't even get my swords out, can I? Right, so... Oh, they're only really low level. Apart from that one there. Ow. Throw some magic at it.
Pretty fancy moves you've got there. Reminds me of the certain game I know.
Fancy that. Not too shabby yourself. You'd make a good sparring partner.
You think so?
It's terrible. It's like, clearly they know who each other are.
Red alert, you two. We're detecting a major power surge.
Oh, is there something else left? I mean, the fact the hunter has 12,000 XP already. It's like, I wonder who he could be. What's going on? Is that an enemy or is that the hunter? Whatever he wants to call himself. No, the hunter's over there. I'm trying to see this thing over here that's in the air.
Oh, abort the mission and get out of there!
It's fine.
I ain't going to leave unfinished business. Can't speak for him, though.
Then allow me. I got this.
We'll easily do that. I'm just holding down circle, it's enough time. Can we get any blindside damage on that? Go attack that one, Noctis, jeez. What do you say, get lost to me?
Had all of them?
Think so.
Nice job. It didn't disappoint.
When have I ever?
Keep it up.
Will do. Now, let's scram.
Nope, wrong way. But yeah, like I said, it's completely obvious who he is. They're not even hiding it. I don't know why they're pretending to not know each other. It's so odd. Silver bangle! Hmm. Bloop. Mithril component. Did we get that from inside the power plant?
Great work in there. As promised, here's your mithril. And thank you for your hard work.
Sure.
Hey, big guy!
So the hunter who went on ahead?
The one and only. How you been, fellas?
Not bad. Whoa, someone did a number on you, though.
You should see the other guy. Anyway, I'm back. And better than ever.
Knocked? Gladdy? I can't believe it!
Hey, thanks for looking after her, Dustin.
So, Gladdy, did you apologize to Noct for storming off like that?
He made it up to me in there.
The power plant? Oh, so you got your hands on some mithril. In that case, I'll go deliver it to Cid. You'll probably want to freshen up first anyway. Come and meet me in Kaim when you're ready.
Very well. Right, so what we'll do is, where is the Regalia right now? Is it out front? It's out down here, isn't it? Yeah. Go to the Regalia, and then I'll teleport us all the way over there, and we'll make our way to the exclamation there. And then there's going to be a long boat trip, by the way. We're heading down here. It's going to go off the edge of the map. There's going to be a very, 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 very long boat trip. Actually, first, before we start setting sail, I'm going to go fix the car, because it really needs to get fixed, and we'll have a look at it getting fixed. So, we'll be at Hammerhead in just a second. Ching, ching. Here we go then, let's speak to Cindy.
Thank your lucky stars, because I whipped up something real special.
Did you now service the Regalia?
She's a right mess. Well, just leave her to me.
500 guilds, not bad really, is it? Considering the damage that has been done to the Regalia.
Y'all just leave her to me.
And this goes there.
There. Good as new.
Maintenance work complete. Look at it. It's so much better now. It's not smashed up and broken. We'll change the paintwork as well while we're here.
So, y'all keeping at it?
I am. Customize the Regalia.
What'll it be? Well, here's what I can do for her.
Well, we'll go with this bow arch or whatever
it
is.
How about the decals?
Because it's just so, that I want to just... No.
What are you fixing to upgrade?
Airflow compensator? Triggers from... What? Laminar flow at the front of the vehicle to improve aerodynamic performance and dramatically boost fuel efficiency. Auxiliary tank as well. Auxiliary gas tank that increases fuel carrying capacity. Oh, good to have that, right.
How's this? Y'all leave the hard work to me.
Look how ugly that looks.
Well, here she is, just like you ordered.
Ew. Ew. We'll keep that like that for a while. Right, so let's make our way to Cape Cam, or whatever the name of the place is, and we'll fast travel there. Ching-ching!
Really looking forward to Iris's cooking.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
Aw, don't be that way. It's different when a girl cooks for you.
Why is it? Makes no sense.
It's weird. Regis has a sword, but doesn't use it.
He doesn't use it because he can't. Who the hell's he think it belonged to?
Why does he bother carrying it at all?
Indeed. I wonder whose the sword really is. It's kind of obvious whose sword it is. But anyway, let's make our way to the exclamation, and then we'll go on a boat trip that will probably just be me being quiet for like, I think it's about 10 minutes of this boat trip. It takes a while to get where you're going. Quite a while. But that's good. It really gives you the sense of it is far away where we're going. It's really, really far away. And you get some good conversations out of it. Plus some good scenery as well. We get basically, it gives you a sense of how big the world really is. And you can revisit here pretty much straight away once you get there. There'll be some time travel.
Let's get a shot with the lighthouse. Hair blowing in the breeze. We'll be seaside supermodels.
Go on then.
Seaside supermodels it is then.
Oh yeah! Seaside supermodels!
Bit too excited about that, but alright. Down we go. Jump over the bush.
Take a shot from here.
Good call. Now it's picture time. Let me get this shot.
I mean, it's completely ignoring Ignis. He's just, it's like he's not even there. We'll save it though. We'll save it.
Oh, love the lighting.
It's not great lighting, to be honest, but alright. But there is another quest up here that we can probably do straight away, because I believe I do already have the item required for this quest. I was going to say quest. Quest. Here we go.
Huh? Hey, you're the cat we saw in Galden. Oh, your paws sure brought you a long way from home, little guy. You must be hungry after all that walking. No restaurants around, though. Wonder if anyone around here knows a thing or two about cat food.
Why don't you try asking Monica?
She mentioned having kept several cats back home.
Wow, and she never gave off a crazy cat lady vibe. I hope we don't have to go all the way back to Galden.
Especially after the cat came all the way to Kaim.
What drew him here anyway?
His dear friend Noct, of course.
Of course. Meow. I'm actually gonna see if we can do that. Hold on. Where's the quests? Because she's not that far away, so let's go speak to her. Because I've not actually finished this cat quest, but I did pick up some cat food, didn't I? We can actually farm there, by the way. That is another side quest that we get from Iris over here. If I actually speak to her, we will get that quest. But I won't speak to her just yet. Right, so where's Monica? There you are!
May I help you with something, Prince Noctis?
I was hoping you could fix some food for me.
Gladly, although I should warn you, our pantry is primarily stocked with vegetables right now.
Oh, not for me. For a cat.
Forgive my misunderstanding. I can prepare something, provided I have the ingredients, but I'm afraid we're all out at the moment.
If you need fish, I can go catch one.
I would be most appreciative. I'm loath to admit, fishing has never come very naturally to me.
Lucky for you, I'm a pro.
Fortunate indeed. Should the tide prove too troublesome, you might also stop by the stand. I recall seeing some cat food on sale.
Yeah, already got the cat food. Catch a dog, blah blah blah, or buy some cat food. Which I did. I already got the cat food. So I've already bought... Have I already bought the cat food? I keep going into the wrong menu. Item. I'm sure I have the cat food. Where would it be, though? Luxury cat food. Yeah, I've already got it. So if I've already got it, do I... What now? Do I just go speak to the cat or Monica again? Jump up. Noctis, jump. Yeah. For once, you wouldn't jump. It jumps at everything with an X. But it didn't jump at that. Let me through here. Where's she gone? Ooh, there's a shiny there. Magic flask. Awesome. We can make more magics now. Good job I went there. Be useful later on. Right, let's go try the cat again. Because we do have some cat food. So, maybe that quest will be done. That's what I was thinking, because I had the cat food already. So I felt like this quest would be really short, but it's longer than I expected it to be. Because it should have been, oh, you've already got cat food, give it to the cat. Done. Rather than go speak to Monica, even though you've already got the cat food. Yeah, the place we're going, over there. Literally beyond the horizon. And it's not a loading screen. It's all the way over there. It is probably just one giant loading screen that we're doing, but you'll see. Oracle Ascension coin.
You better save her every last morsel, buddy. That cat food there cost us a fortune.
You really got a soft spot for animals, don't you?
They bring out a nicer Noct.
Could try being nicer to us.
Could, but I won't.
Harsh. Alright then, that's the cat quest done. Right, so, let's go see what's happening with Cid. Hand over the Sky Gemstone to upgrade the circular saw. I didn't know I could do that here, but I'll say yes.
Alright, I'll give you a call when it's ready.
Did not expect that.
Stand up straight, boy.
Will do.
Ah, y'all brace yourself for power.
Yeah, Reddy didn't expect that, but okay. Can I not? Once you depart, you will lose access to the open world for a while, only a little while, and rental chocobos will automatically return to the post. Set sail for Altissia. Yep. Right, so we're getting ready to set sail. Right, here we go then. On our way down. Still walk around, it's very creepy. This elevator does go up as well. We'll be looking at that later. But we have got some side quest parts coming up soon, because once we get to Altissia, we'll pretty much end the part there. And then I'll wander around the open world that apparently we can't go back to for a while, but we can. You know, just it lied to me at that point, by the way.
Look, Prince Noctis, even the Marshal came to say goodbye.
Did he?
I heard the Regalia's going on the boat with you.
Is it?
I guess it's goodbye for now.
Get out the way, Prompto.
Something I gotta get off my chest.
What's that?
I'm sorry. Sorry I wasn't there for your father. I swore an oath to protect the king, but I wasn't strong enough to uphold it.
Ain't nothing nobody could have done to stop what happened.
Yeah. I realize that.
But you need to realize just what you mean to the boys by your side.
I do.
Even if they can't solve your problems, you can't hide what's going on from them. It hurts like hell. Remember, those ain't your bodyguards. They're your brothers. Trust in them, always.
Indeed. Right, can I look at the picture thing now like I wanted to? Oh, it's just a book. Oh god, that's going to be really weird to read. A rotted soul under blighted sky. A dreaded plague the wicked has wrought. In the light of the gods, sword sworn at his side. Against the dark, the night king's battle is fought. From the heavens high to the blessed below shines the beam of a peace long besought. Long live thy line and this stone divine for the night when all comes to naught. What? All right. Yes. Uh-huh. That's what I'll go with. I'll go with yes. Anything special around? Any shinies? No shinies. All right, we'll speak to Kor.
You can never have too many tools. Here, learn to wield not only weapons, but magic as well.
A magic flask! Fantastic. Glad, get out of the way. Alright, trying to get through here. Right, let's set sail. Let's set sail for Altissia. Ooh, maybe there's a shiny over here. I knew it! I knew there was going to be shiny somewhere! I sense these things. Hi, potion! Oh, it's not going to respond, is it? So it's not even bother saying hi to it. Any other potions? Nothing out the way, so maybe I can have a look. Right, nope. Let's go. That's what I wanted to do. You can see the X in the screen, and what I clearly wanted to do was jump.
Waiting for an invitation? Get your asses on board!
Hey! Your Majesty!
What's up?
Please! Come back soon! We need our king!
Yeah! Count on it!
End of chapter. It's very, very quick chapter that, but, you know. Well, up to level 50 at least. Yeah. Right, pictures, what we got? Anything good? Yeah. That is a really creepy smile. What are they doing? Why is that such a bad picture? That would have been a great picture. But no, we got a pole or a pipe. It's a pipe. Based on the ones in the background, it's a pipe that's in the way. Where was he? He was not there during this scene. How did he take this picture? He's a very good photographer. There we go. We'll save that one, because that one's nice. There's Thinky. What's her name? The one that has her eyes closed. She's right there in the picture. They didn't even notice. You do get actually get a trophy for her appearing in the picture. I got it previously on my first playthrough on one picture. She wasn't actually in the picture, like, at all. I was like properly like having a look and everything, and she wasn't there at all. She just wasn't there. But this one, she's clearly right there. I can see her. Yeah, I'm going to save that one as well, because that's a good picture to save. So yeah, those two, that'll probably be the thumbnail for this part. It depends if we get a good thumbnail from what happens when we reach Altissia, because it's a really good looking place. But like I said previously, there's going to be a lot of talking during this boat bit, so I'm going to be quiet during it, because there's no way I can talk during their conversation. So, probably speak to you in like 10 minutes. Oh, I forgot about this bit, obviously. Chapter 9, Callings. Noctis receives a warm send-off as he sets sail for Altissia in high spirits. The prince goes forth, ostensibly, to seek the blessing of the Hydrian, which will enable him to challenge the Empire's might, but his true heart's desire is to find Lunafreya, his betrothed.
The wedding day arrives, but alas, without the bride. Of course, we've come for the Hydrian, and you've gone to such lengths to prepare.
Merely my duty.
Ah, but for an outsider to lead the Imperial army must be a battle in and of itself. You've spoken to Lady Lunafreya.
No.
That obstinate secretary standing in the way. While you rush off to slay the Hydrian for your poor sister's sake. I know the price of the Covenant.
You know, I've always wanted to go sailing like this.
Not many opportunities living in Insomnia.
Out here, it's just us and the horizon. It's amazing. It's life-changing.
We've quite a ways to go until we reach Altissia, so keep gushing to your heart's content.
When we step off the boat, we'll be in a foreign country.
The anticipation alone is a foreign sensation.
And to think this is where we were headed to begin with.
We've been through a lot.
And there's still more to come.
So next on the docket is Leviathan.
What sort of deity are we dealing with?
A serpent said to embody the roar and rage of the sea.
We'll have to see for ourselves.
Can't let Lady Lunafreya do all the heavy lifting. You must be so psyched to see her.
Luna?
Yeah.
Well, we need to make sure she's all right before anything else.
Indeed. Her well-being is top priority.
Don't like this going down on Imperial turf.
You think Lady Lunafreya's in danger there?
The Empire did invade Lucis for the ring. I have no faith their ruthless ambitions will stop short of harming the Oracle One.
Without the ring, the crystal's no more than a rock.
I suppose. Does anyone know how Lady Lunafreya came to have the ring?
It seems likely His Majesty entrusted it to her safekeeping back at the Crown City.
So she's held onto it this whole time, all the way to Altissia.
The ring is important, and so is Leviathan. But Luna comes first.
You know, I was thinking back to our encounter with Regis. Do you recall an apparatus in place of his arm?
Yeah, I remember.
Seems he lost his old one in the invasion. But in its place, he seems to have acquired new power.
Power?
That would help explain how a son of Tenebrae suddenly came to command Niflheim's army.
Now that you mention it, his strength did seem sort of supernatural. I just chalked it up to the Oracle lineage.
His ancestry may be part of it, but that alone wouldn't account for his freakish strength.
I wonder what could have happened to him.
There's a disturbing rumor about. Lord Regis has taken to brandishing His Majesty's sword.
My dad's.
And what's the big idea behind that?
That his power's the same as the power of kings?
I cannot say for sure, but I have my doubts. Regis wears the sword, yet doesn't wield it.
For all his newfound powers, he's still the Chancellor's lapdog, holding on to the enemy king's sword like some badge of honor.
It might help if we knew what he was after.
Who can say?
What are the odds the Empire will crash the pool party with Leviathan?
Consider it a guarantee. They felled a god to prevent Noct from receiving his blessing. They'll do so again.
But we beat him to the big guy, thanks to our friendly guide.
Never know which way that one's gonna move next.
The Chancellor has an agenda all his own.
Sometimes it helps, like when he called off his army and let us escape.
But he was still a creep about it.
Well, it feels like he's only helping us because he wants something. I just don't know what.
Reckon we'll see him again?
Certainly hope not.
Not your type?
No love lost for phonies.
As Gladio said, his actions are motivated not by altruism, but by self-interest. And when he does come to our aid, I see only condescension in his eyes.
Yeah, can't argue with that.
Ever think you think too much?
Sometimes, but it's always preferable to the alternative.
Are we there yet?
Well, didn't you say you always wanted to go sailing?
Yeah, but all this ocean gets kind of bland after a while.
Last time I checked, it was amazing and life-changing.
So, soon you'll have your old man's ring back.
Yeah, when we arrive in Altissia.
Good thing. To him, it was his heritage.
Is that what my dad said?
Carrying a royal line ain't a task to be taken lightly. For a small thing, that ring can sure weigh heavy. After he became king, I only ever saw his face in the paper.
Wait, weren't you at the coronation?
No, I was long gone from the city.
You must have been invited, at least.
Had a fallen out of sorts with your old man. Right at the end of the trip.
You did?
I was given to understand you stayed in touch.
We buried the hatchet years later, but never talked face to face again. Should have paid a visit while I had the chance. Well, no use dwelling on it now. Got the Regalia in the hold, but y'all gonna stay in Altissia for a good while, right?
Yes, we believe so.
In that case, I'll tune her up for y'all. Not that I'll have much to do, though. Well, with Cindy looking after the old girl,
If you say she's good, she must be great.
She was never afraid of hard work. Heaven knows she had a hard childhood.
Hard childhood?
He means her parents.
Lost them both when she was little. Was big enough to understand, though. And to hurt. But you wouldn't guess that, seeing her now.
Not at all. She's always so cheerful.
Well, that ought to tell you how far she's come.
Now you must have seen your fair share of Altissia by now.
Yeah. Only done been the once. Stayed a good while, though.
What's it like?
Big old city.
Big. Okay.
Well, it ain't the crown city.
Different. Got it. You'll see for yourself. Foreign lands seldom lend themselves to trite explanations.
Change of scenery ought to do you good.
Well, I'm all talked out. Can't be far to Altissia now, right?
We'll be there in no time. Nice having the wind at our backs.
Lodgings are our first order of business.
All work and no play?
Makes Ignis a dull boy.
Someone has to babysit you too.
Well, you're welcome to sleep in the wild.
Ain't no hotel, but I know a fella has a place.
Hey now.
Wescom ran with Regis and me way back when.
Oh, was he the other one in that photo with the garage?
Yep. Runs himself a diner or a cafe or something. Go and see for yourselves.
Sure.
Does the place have a name?
McGee or Magoo or Mago, that's the one.
Nice.
You can count on old Wes. He'll chew your ears off.
The government issued a statement promising that the reasons behind awakening the Hydrian would be clarified in the ceremonial address.
Got a signal!
Delivering the address will be Lady Lunafreya, who was previously reported dead. This will mark her first public appearance since the violence that befell the signing ceremony.
Lady Lunafreya's gonna give a speech?
Sounds like it.
Lord knows. This world could use some wisdom.
Won't be much longer now, Noct.
Yeah.
Does this vessel have an entry permit?
Entry permit?
Relax. I got one. Here.
That's as old as they get. Seems in order. You may pass.
Prepared in advance.
Could say that. 30-odd years ago.
That's what the guy meant by old.
Lucky us, huh?
That could have ended badly.
We're finally here in Altissia, and it looks awesome, and I can finally speak. After such a long time. I could have pressed skip at any moment, but it was like, no. Careful, Sid, careful. Jeez. Bit close there, mate. They've easily gone off. And the current would surely pull you over there. Beautiful. Alright, here we are in Altissia then. Let's go over here first though. Maybe there'll be a shiny. Probably not though, I mean, you know. I like the music here. It's very, very nice. And we've got some gondolas as well. That's how you actually get around this city. I mean, you can walk around, but you may as well take some gondolas. I mean, there's gondolas everywhere, so, you know. What's this thing over here? Saluna Cascades and Gourmet Tour, Altissia. The fish market in the Muscia district overflows with fresh seafood caught in the Allura and Silgian waters. Alright then. Alright, let's go into Altissia, though. Let's see if there's any shinies around.
What's next? Immigration? What do you mean? There's still more?
Yeah. Just another country.
Sir, what is the purpose of your visit?
Purpose,
ask Ignis.
Ignis, a little help?
Oh, utterly hopeless. We are scholars of the culinary arts, and we've come to study the renowned cuisine of your fair nation.
Is that so? I wish you an enlightening stay.
Another one you owe me.
Indeed. Last time I played this, I went with Sid and he had to pay him off. Basically, I had to bribe the guy, so I just saved some money. Awesome.
You want to check Wescombe's place out?
Yeah, let's all go to Mago.
Perhaps we'll even make it in time for tea.
And we'd better start looking now.
I'm so like Ignis, or Ignis is so like me. One of the two.
It's a photographer's dream.
What a city.
So someone caught the secretary of Mago again. Shoot.
Expect some more things on the signs, but nothing.
Now let's hurry over to the arena.
Frame rate's a bit dodgy, though. Gondolas! The gondolas of Altissia run along the city's main waterways, with shops located near major attractions such as Listro Park and Arena Galviano? They are a great choice for tourists. Plus, the elevated waterways offer spectacular views of the city that should not be missed. We'll have a look at them at some point. But I want to make our way to where we need to go, which is the hotel. For now.
They're extending the exhibit for Lady Lunafreya's wedding dress. The Vivian Westwood? But wasn't that a memorial for her passing? Well, now it's a memorial for her safe return. Let's go see it while we still can.
Oh, could that be the dress we read about in the papers?
Doubtless. The designer's name is the same.
Want to check it out?
That depends on the groom. Might still be a sore spot. What with his wedding getting called off?
Who says we can't call it back on? It can still happen.
True enough. Let's keep an eye out for it.
We'll go look at that in the next part as part of, or one of the next parts, because, like I said, we've got some side quests coming up. Yeah, I like the fact that they split up and face away from each other during their conversation. Very odd. Very odd. But yeah, we're heading for a hotel right now that's got 3 times XP. 3 times.
Hello, boys. Feel free to browse at your leisure.
What have you got for us?
So,
nothing.
What do you want to do?
Oracle card? A card. A mystical card said to place fate in one's own hands. Enhances spirit mildly.
Stop by again sometime.
No, you're right. Not got anything interesting for me. I'm sure there's a shiny around here somewhere on one of these piers. It's probably across the bridge. There's a little planted pot for some reason.
Huh.
Indeed, huh. Weird. Where's the shinies, though? There's always shinies everywhere. Wait, what was that? There was a check there. Hassinerna Street? Hassinerna Street? Something like that. No idea. Is there really no shinies? Where's my shinies at? What's some shinies? There's a gondola. There's a shiny, I'm happy now. Glass gemstone! Where are we? I'm lost, I've not been here before.
I just feel like there's no point in going into work anymore. Like I'm not welcome.
You're overthinking it. Come on, let's go somewhere you're always welcome.
Yeah, Mago sounds nice.
Alright, Makoto. That's fine, or Kirito, take your pick. Isn't that another shiny? No, it's just white paper on the floor. Fair enough. Where am I going?
Anything happen while I was gone?
Yeah, the car got roomier.
Smartass.
Well, he's not inaccurate. Spirit ZX? The hell is that? No idea. No idea at all. Right, let's head back to where we were. Found some shinies, so I'm happy now. It's all about them shinies. There's a person there.
Huh?
Other way. Where are you guys? It's a weapon shop.
What are you looking for?
Oh, blood sword.
Come back whenever you need supplies.
I will do. But yeah, you can see on the map there's a hotel. Because you can see the beds. Let's go up the stairs. We'll go that way. It's a shame we don't have access to this place until this part.
Have a look, Noct.
This way to the dress?
Yep, same street as the estate.
Seems we're on the right track.
Screw it, we'll go see the dress. We may as well. It's not that far away now. I already know that much. I think it's down here somewhere. Yes, I thought it was. Oh no, it's up there. It's up top. We need to go up. Such a confusing place. Shiny! Golden needle. Come on.
They spared no expense on the dress. I'm glad I caught it when I did. If the prince is still alive, they should go ahead with a wedding. Yeah, they just need him to show up. Doesn't he know it's rude to keep a lady waiting?
The people have spoken.
Oh, the dress is so beautiful. I want mine to be like that.
And it shall be, my love, as surely as I am your Prince Noctis.
Looks like the prince has a following as
well. One hell of a crowd.
And that's the dress. My word.
Everyone looks so happy. And it's all because of this one dress.
Yeah.
Real glad for you that Lady Lunafreya is safe and sound.
Yeah.
Well, that settles it. You gotta make it happen. Become a symbol of the peace. After we tie up all the loose ends, let's think about the ceremony.
A fine idea.
Yeah, I'll think about it.
It became night at the wrong moment.
Huh.
Well, dusk, I suppose. So they turned the light off, so it ruined the mood. Oh well. Can't control that sort of thing, so it's fine. Right, let's go to the hotel and end this part. We'll also show what I'm planning to do and how I plan to get back to the open world, which it said I couldn't return to for a while. Such lies. It's such lies. Because I can easily get back.
That Aranea, she's a little different.
Certainly doesn't fit the Imperial Army profile.
Indeed. Do like her character, though. Hopefully there'll be some, like, proper DLC with her. Because apparently there's DLC coming where she'll be, like, a... Like, you can add her to the party. But I don't want to just add her to the party. I want to be part of the group. Like, proper story around her and stuff like that. It'd be awesome. Alright, so, hotel. We just passed it.
See that over there?
And what about it?
What we're looking at, Glad? Yo. What is it? What?
Ah!
Touring the town, the news of famous gondolas. Experience the city on the sea the way it was meant to be. Altissia Waterways Transit Authority.
How about a ridela on the gondola?
Really? Ridela on the gondola? Oh dear. Right. So, as we can see here, this one here.
Greetings.
3x XP, 15,000 gil. I need to go sell some stuff if I want to use that.
Very well.
But, if we see here...
Gentiana.
Ahead lies a future uncertain, yet sure is the astral memory wherein the king may walk.
Through Umbra's power, you can now revisit past memories. Summon him when you rest at lodgings. Characters will retain their current level and abilities. Rental chocobos will automatically return to the post. The place you collected, called Umbra, will be set as your last rest point. Messengers and amulets, that's what we wanted. Right, I'm going to go sell stuff and we're going to stay at the 3x hotel. And then I'll return back to the open world and we'll end this part. Right, so what do I want to sell in order to get the money I need? Well, that's a lot of money.
Thank
there.
You.
So I only need 15,000. Wait, that one's... I think they give me the... I'm going to sell them, screw it. I was going to say they give me the XP, but if I'm staying at a hotel like this, it's worth to sell it that way, because then I get the XP a different way. And I need 15,000 giant crab pincers. Basically, I'm selling with anything I've got more than one of. Ching, ching. Nearly done it, nearly done it.
Bye
there we
now.
Go. So happy I've got this bit of DLC from my Ultimate Collector's Edition, though. Otherwise, I'd have to pay 30,000 gil. 30,000.
Welcome back. Will you be requiring a room?
I will.
It's bedtime.
Huh.
Ding-a-ding-a-ding. As you can see, that's the gondola routes, by the way. Doom, doom, doop, doom. That it? 3x XP, and that's all we got. I was just showing it off anyway, that's the point. Right, so, could have that. No. No.
Hey, this one's pretty good.
I know. I dig it too.
I do, yeah. That might be the thumbnail.
Well taken.
That's a good one as well. We'll hold on to that one. I don't know which one would be the good thumbnail there. Because I might try both as the thumbnail, and whichever one suits it the best, I'll go with. That's terrible.
Well taken.
Well, you would say that, wouldn't you?
Not bad.
Well taken.
Maybe I can make a living out of this.
I don't think so. Not yet, anyway.
Not bad.
Alright, yep, so we'll go with either that one or that one as the thumbnail, whichever looks best. I'm not sure just yet. You'll know, because it will be the thumbnail. You know. Right, so anyway, let's go speak to Umbra and head back and do some side quests in the next part. Saving. Right, where's Umbra? Try and remember how to access Umbra. There we are. Call Umbra from there. Right, so we'll have several different options here. We can ask for some poor, obviously, or go back to the past. But once we proceed on with the story, we get two options, which is either return to Altissia or past Lucis. It's a good photo. We'll save the photo, but I'm not using it as a thumbnail. There we go then. Oh, phone call.
Howdy, Prince. Do you mind swinging by the garage for a hot minute? We've been experiencing some awful strange shakes back here in Lead. The hunters are already looking into it, but I reckon they could use a couple more hands.
Got it. On our way.
All I can think right now is shiny, 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 shiny. Right, so here's our aim. Oh, hold on, what's this? Oh, is it just the door? Why was it shining? That was creepy. Right, so our aim for the next part is to go off and finish off the quest that we've currently got. Because I've got a few to hand in all over the place. Then what we'll do... Why have we got one down at Golden Key? Didn't know one appeared there. Is that to do with the cat? No? Coctura? I don't know. But yeah, right, what we're going to do. Hand in what we've got to hand in. Then we'll start doing the quests here in Lastalum. And then we'll see how long it takes and we'll start working our way round other quests. That's another fishing one. Oh no, we got more fishing ones to do. So yeah, we'll see you in the next few parts for some more side quests. And if you're not interested in the side quests, we'll see you when we're back with the story one. And we'll be back in Altissia. So, whichever one you're going for, we'll see you then. Bye-bye for now. That road's not a mistake, by the way.